sighted, engaging.
That felt good.
Arrived on Balmora. Excellent. Your contact there is Lieutenant Malavai Quinn. I trust you'll find him most helpful.
I have no doubt, Master.
This is an important mission, and I only entrust the finest. Quinn will meet you in his offices at Sobrick headquarters. We will speak again as soon as he has briefed you.
Get ready for the bumpy ride.
Sir, I apologize, sir. It was the best I could do.
If that's your best, you're useless to me. I can shoot you dead with a clear conscience. Is that what you want?
No, sir.
Then focus, Jillins. Dismissed. I apologize for the delay, my lord. Lieutenant Malavai Quinn, I'm to be your liaison here on Balmora.
You say liaison, I say servant.
Yes, I'm in your charge for as long as you are on this planet. Lord Barriss will brief you personally, but I'm to acquaint you with the climate here on Balmora first.
By all means, go ahead.
Even though the Empire wrestled control of Balmora from the Republic during the war, we were never able to completely eradicate them. There is a rather sizable resistance movement. No one wants to admit it, but it's clear that the Republic is backing it.
Maybe I'll have time to do something about that.
Something tells me your presence here will leave an indelible impression on the state of things. And I look forward to it. I have a secure line to Lord Barriss. I'll patch him through immediately.
Ah, I see you've convened with my apprentice. Very good, Lieutenant. Leave us. Quinn owes his career to me, but we should keep the details of your mission between the two of us. We must act swiftly. Noman Carr's Padawan has directed the Jedi's suspicions to my undercover spy there on Balmora. Do you recall this?
Of course. I remember everything.
Good. I'll get to the point. My spy is Commander Rylan of the Republic Resistance. He is the central contact for all my operatives in this sector. Unfortunately, Quinn is tracking an investigator that the Jedi have sent. That means we have to cover our tracks before you kill Rylan. Your first mandate is to destroy evidence that links Rylan to the sabotaging of Balmora's defense systems during the war. To do so, you must break into the satellite control tower. Quinn reports that the tower is a death trap of mechanical security.
Are there any special requirements?
Quinn has everything you'll need. I'll summon him back. Remember, he is not to know the reason for your mission. I'll be in touch.
My lord, I've prepared what you need for your assault on the satellite control tower. In order to destroy the mainframe, you'll mount this charge to the base and activate it. Then contact me and I'll be able to detonate.
Mark your progress and see that the charge is armed. I will detonate once you are a safe distance. But first, I have Darth Barriss on hollow for you. I will retreat and leave the line secure for the two of you.
Apprentice, we have one more potentially compromising thing to take care of before you can confront my spy, Commander Rylan. It involves invading a Republic keep to find a lowly ensign named Dermot. He is Rylan's son. And the commander confided his true identity to him. Ensign Dermot must be silenced permanently.
Rylan was foolish to tell his son.
The one chink in his otherwise flawless armor. I'll signal Quinn to give you the details. Be swift.
My lord, Ensign Dermot is being detained in the brig of the Republic Crater Outpost, awaiting questioning by the mysterious agent Barriss has me tracking. I will alert you if the investigator appears to be heading there. I assume you wish to get to Dermat before she does.
It's none of your business, Imperial.
I apologize, my lord. My inquiring mind often gets the best of me. I won't delay you any longer. Good luck on your mission, my lord. I'll be here if you need anything.
Pipe down, Dermat. There's something going on outside. trying to listen.
Oh, come on, Six, throw me a bone. Who's this agent that's coming to interrogate me? At least answer me that, will ya? Fine, stay clamped. I don't care who it is, I ain't talking. Nobody's gonna get nothing out of me. Nothing!
What?
All right, I ain't proud. I give. My dad's an Imperial agent.
What did you say? Your dad is a what?
Yes, please repeat that, Junior.
Oh, no.
This is a restricted area. What are you doing here? Who are you?
It's not a who. It's a what? It's a Sith.
He's going to need a new pair of pants.
Who cares what Dermot needs? You gave me enough time to get what I need.
I have a very bad feeling about this.
Take a look behind yourself, Sith. That's what two squads of the Republic's finest look like.
You're about to see what two squads of the Republic's deadest look like.
Come on, men. Let's send this Sith home in a body bag.
Six? Six! Come on, talk to me, Six. Get up, man.
Look at me, Ensign Dermot.
But if I don't look, then... Maybe you're not really here, and... Oh, blast, I looked. Please, I know why you're here. The Republic. The Republic's investigating my dad, and an agent's coming to put the screws to me. But I won't break. I promise. Let me live. My dad's secret is safe with me. I'm a rock.
You'd crack the minute someone looked at you funny. I just heard you confess to Zix.
Yeah, but he's dead now, so he can't tell anyone. My father's done so much for the Empire. Look, maybe the apple fell off the tree. Kind of far from the tree, but it's still... Look, the apple's still... Look, I'm not exactly sure where I was going with that, but please don't kill me.
I'm willing to consider alternatives. Is there another solution?
Hold on. Yeah. I just had a thought pop into my head. Quick, before it pops out. My assignment here was in the medical lab, moving supplies and making deliveries. And the docs there were working on something really cool. It was a drug that was supposed to create temporary amnesia, but it wiped the mind totally clean. The test subjects didn't even know their own names.
So you want me to wipe your mind?
Wow. You Force users really can read thoughts. Yeah. You could break into the lab and bring back the drug. I'll overdose and not know nothing no more. That way my dad's secret identity's safe.
You'll be getting a second chance at life.
I've never had a second chance before. The med lab's in the back building. The head doc kept a small supply of the drug in his footlocker. I'll wait right here. Like I have a choice. And there was a time I almost shot myself in the foot. That was a close one. What else? Oh, you're back. I was just recalling my life, trying to remember the highlights since I'm about to have my memory wiped clean. I think I'm done. Not much to reflect on. So, did you get the drug? I'm actually looking forward to starting over.
Try not to screw up your new life.
At least if I do. Hopefully it'll be a new and more exciting ways. Here goes nothing, I guess.
Who are you?
Don't play dumb with me.
Is dumb a game? Can you teach me how to play?
I leave you to figure that out yourself. Enjoy your new life.
I think I'm supposed to say thank you?
Wow. Too bad there isn't more of that drug. I got a few memories I could let go of.
Should I take that personally, Vet?
Of course not. I'll never be able to forget you. Let's move on, shall we? Ellie, let's relax and kick off our boots.
Have you ever heard of Nocturne? Pirate. Terrified the criminal world for a few decades.
He destroyed the Wrath Cartel and the Vandalhelm Combine in some giant power grab. Same guy.
Yeah, same guy. Weird to think of him that way. Nocturne was the most famous killer in the galaxy. But he set me free. I was still slaving it up for Three Eyes when he crossed Nock. Or maybe he just had something Nock wanted. I never did ask.
Did any of the gang survive the encounter?
You mean anyone that wasn't owned as property? No, they did not. I'm still not sure how Nock got his speeders into the camp. One minute they weren't there, and then they were. He was ruthless, but not a thug, you know? Sort of a pirate prince. Freed all the slaves, and told them they could join up, or go their own way.
To truly lead and inspire fear, people must see that you are in control.
That was Nock. Cool as the belly of an ice lizard. I was the smallest on the crew, and mining had taught me to fit in tight spaces. Nock's crew showed me how to steal. For a long time, I didn't feel bad about stealing. So much had been taken from me.
It must have been hard for you.
Well, it's a long time ago anyway. Let's get back to work, yeah?
Must be honest. Your success at the Satellite Control Station and Republic Crater Outpost has surprised me, my lord. I computed the likelihood of success as nearly negligible. In my assessment, however, I only considered the capabilities of a typical Sith. Clearly, you are not a typical Sith. I will adjust future calibrations to account for your unprecedented abilities.
Don't worry about it, Quinn.
I take pride in accuracy. Otherwise, I'm no good to you. Lord Barriss is pleased. He says it's time to zero in on your prime directive, and he awaits your contact. My barracks are yours. Activate the holocommunicator in the next room to speak with Lord Barriss. The Lion is secure.
Don't wander off.
I'll be right here if needed, my lord.
I hope you can see the smile on my face, apprentice. You are turning me into a true believer.
Wait a minute. Let me pinch myself.
I'm sure you're impatient to complete your time on that little rock. With the satellite tower computer destroyed and Commander Rylon's son neutralized, my spy's tracks are covered. Now the only threat to Rylon ever being exposed is the man himself. It's time to end that threat. Permanently.
Do I have a choice in the matter?
I like that idleness makes you disagreeable. Just be sure to give Commander Rylon an honorable death. It's the least we can do. I've had him embedded within enemy ranks for decades. The extent of his contribution to the Empire's interests is unrivaled.
The man is a hero. Pity he has to die.
He has always known the risk. The Jedi Investigator must have no hard evidence that Rylon was killed to silence him. It must look like anything but a targeted execution. Annihilate everyone there.
Sounds like overkill to me.
Your objection is noted. The order remains. I've summoned Lieutenant Quinn. He'll prepare you for your final task.
Your final target is the Balmoran Arms Factory. The Resistance forces recently captured it and made it their headquarters. An incursion into the Arms Factory will be a monumental feat. I'm excited by the prospect of you laying waste to that place.
Just spit out the details, Imperial. Try to contain yourself.
Yes, my lord. I will not stray from the facts again. All right. The Republic Command Center is deep inside the arms factory, the most heavily protected installation on the planet. In order to reach Commander Rylorn, you will have to make your way past all of the factory's defenses, which are considerable.
The tougher, the better.
Stationed inside are an estimated 1,000 of the Republic's best-trained soldiers. Specifically, Rylorn's elite squadron is responsible for some of the most precise, improbable resistance victories on Balmora. They're legendary.
Sounds like you admire them, Lieutenant.
I've marveled at their tactical exploits, that's all. It will be a bright day on Balmora when they are eliminated. One final thing. The investigator that the Jedi sent has been concentrating her activity around the arms factory. I have her under minute-by-minute surveillance. If she becomes a problem, I'll contact you on your comlink.
I'll answer if I feel like it.
I hope there will be no reason to disturb you. I will be here to salute you when the Balmoran arms factory is a smoking husk, my lord.
Factory is under attack. Headquarters has been breached and casualties are severe.
Keep your wits, Captain. What do we know of the enemy?
Target is carving a bloody path in this direction. Unconfirmed reports suggest it's Sith.
Consider them confirmed.
Commander, contact confirmed. The enemy is Sith. Repeat, the enemy is...
I can see that, Captain. Shut up.
Sith, I know why you're here. Be aware that these are the finest troops I've commanded in all my decades of duty.
Am I supposed to turn tail and run now?
My men and I would be disappointed if you did. Captain Everton, engage at will and hold the line. I'm coming with reinforcements. Right on out.
You're about to find out what we're made of.
You're made of bones that break and blood that spills.
You don't intimidate us. We've killed your kind before.
Enough talk, Captain. I can smell your fear.
Now taste death. Men, attack! Commander, he should have been here by now.
Your commander left you to die.
No, he's safe. All that matters is he's safe.
Please, enough of this.
Commander, no! Run! Save yourself!
Just put him out of his misery, Sith.
Before I end his suffering, I want you to tell him the truth about you.
Commander, what? I don't understand.
I'm sorry, Captain Elegin. All these years, I have been a loyal soldier of the Empire.
No. I can't believe...
It's unfortunate they were on the wrong side. They were excellent soldiers and exceptional men.
Why didn't you convert them to our cause?
I follow Barriss's orders to the letter. Recruitment was never my purpose here. I serve for the glory of the Empire, but the life of a spy is a slippery one. In essence, I had to become a Republic soldier, and I've done things against the Empire that have sickened me.
But for the greater good, Commander.
I have lived believing, hoping that was the case, my friend. Today was inevitable. I knew Lord Barriss would eventually have to eliminate me. but I'm proud to have been of service all this time.
I'm honored to be the one to kill you.
Before I embrace my end, there is one thing I must know. My son. He was the only thing in the world that was truly mine. And in love or weakness, I told him my secrets. I know you had to cover my tracks, but please tell me, did he face his fate well?
His chin was held high, Commander.
Then I can die with a smile. When they find my corpse, there must be evidence of a valiant fight. We must make this look convincing, Sith. So I will not hold back. I will fight you as though you are my mortal enemy.
It will give me no pleasure to cut you down.
Our duty is often difficult, friend. Tell Lord Barriss it has been my great honor to serve him.
I believe we've got trouble. I heard your entire conversation with Commander Rigel.
What from my conversation makes you think we have trouble?
I told you that I've had the Jedi Investigator surveilled and that she's been snooping around the arms factory. Apparently she bugged Rylorn's quarters, and as she listened in on your conversation, I heard what she heard. The Investigator knows everything, my lord.
The same can be said of you now.
Yes, but I pose no risk to Lord Barriss. If this Investigator gets away, she'll expose everything. She was heading to her ship, but I had my men move in and cut her off from the Republic landing bay. I am systematically blocking her avenues of transmission and escape, herding that Republic scum to her only hope, the spaceport at Sobrick.
How does she expect to survive an Imperial spaceport?
My men report that she's wielding a lightsaber, my lord. This Investigator is a Jedi Knight. Unless you stop her, she's more than capable of fighting her way through the spaceport and commandeering a ship. I'll be able to delay the Jedi long enough for you to engage. But I advise caution when facing her.
Killing Jedi is old hat for me.
Then my concern is unfounded. My apologies. I will gather my remaining men and meet you at the spaceport. We will crush this Jedi.
You're too late, Sith. I already transmitted the conversation between you and Commander Rylon to the Jedi Council. Noman Carr has his proof. Now Master Carr and his Padawan will track down and expose every Sith agent in the galaxy.
I'll let you enjoy your delusions.
Enjoyment is not part of the equation. I have purity of purpose. I seek neither thrills nor satisfaction. Unlike you, I am calm.
You know nothing about me.
I know that by the shortcuts you have taken, your strength is thin. The dark side shall fail you, Sith. Save yourself, surrender, and the Jedi Council will give you every opportunity to discover redemption.
I offer you the chance to surrender and live, Jedi.
Surrender is not possible. I am in the right. I won't kill you, Sith, but I am leaving. So, I'm going to have to incapacitate you. Victory means nothing. The damage has been done. The proof has been transmitted. So deal the death blow, Sith. I am at peace, knowing that the greater good has been served.
I hate to burst your bubble, Jedi. No, that's a lie. I'm reveling in it. I intercepted your transmission. The Jedi know nothing.
Your failure is complete. How do you feel now?
Gloat all you like. It means nothing. I remain at peace. And Noman Carr and his Padawan will still defeat you.
I'm impressed with your fortitude, Jedi.
The Force and the Jedi way give me a sense of something larger than myself. I am resigned. Strike me down. I offer no further resistance.
You are subdued. There's no sense in destroying you.
I will take the wounded Jedi into custody, my lord. Your lightsaber, if you will, Jedi. Men, escort her to her new home in the main prison. I'm sure you know what you're doing, my lord, but sparing the Jedi is a curious choice.
A Jedi investigator will be a wealth of information.
Of course, my lord. What matters is the threat has been averted. Lord Barriss will be anxious to learn what became of this. When you're ready, I'll contact him from my office.
I'm anxious to get off this planet.
Excellent. I'll go prepare. I'll be waiting in my barracks. It's not my place, Lord Barriss. I leave that for your apprentice to convey.
Then step aside, Lieutenant. My apprentice has arrived. Nice of you to join us. Quinn refuses to update me, insisting the privilege be yours. I assume the Jedi investigator has been stopped.
I handled it. Your doubts and worries are becoming intolerable.
Considering recent developments, yes, I had much concern. I had hoped to avoid confronting the Jedi, but our hand was forced. What matters most is that Rylon can no longer be exposed. And how would you assess Lieutenant Quinn's contribution?
He did his part.
Lieutenant, my apprentice's demeanor notwithstanding, I have been impressed with your efforts. You have more than made up what is owed to me. I'm putting you up for a captaincy and transmitting an executive order allowing you to station wherever you choose. You are dismissed.
Thank you, Lord Barriss. If my actions benefit the Empire, they benefit me. I would have done the same regardless of our past. My lord, before I depart, it's been my extreme honor to serve you. You are the epitome of everything the Empire stands for.
You've been dismissed, Imperial.
Until we meet again, I salute you, my lord.
He will have his hands full. There are powerful Imperials dedicated to keeping him down. But if Quinn can overcome them and rise to the station he deserves, there is great hope for our Imperial allies.
Can we get on with our business?
You are quite right, Apprentice. Quinn's fate is of small consequence compared to our affairs. Your presence on Balmora is no longer needed. Return to your ship when you're ready to leave. I'll contact you there.
We're leaving, right? On to our next exercise in domination and destruction?
I only dominate and destroy as a last resort.
Yeah, right. You must have a short list of resorts then. Well, I hope the next place we end up has a beach.
My lord, I hope you don't find my appearance here obtrusive. I beg an audience.
I'd hoped I'd seen the last of you.
My apologies, my lord. Perhaps my presence is unwelcome, but I hope to remedy that. As you know, Lord Barriss enabled my reassignment anywhere I choose. It is an evolution I've longed for and assumed would never come. Aiding your mission on this planet has reawakened the ambition I began my career with, to make the most profound impact possible for the Empire.
Good luck with that.
I don't want to leave it to luck, my lord. I cannot think of a more glorious and honorable way to make a difference in the galaxy than to serve you. I'm here to pledge myself to you. I'm ready and willing to serve in whatever capacity you see fit.
You should be so lucky.
Yeah, I recommend the experience.
My lord, if given the chance, I know I will prove myself to you. I'm a top-notch pilot, military strategist, and a deadly shot. I can fly this ship, plan your battles, assess your enemies, and kill them. You won't find a more tireless and loyal subject. I offer my military prowess and dedicate every ounce of my strength to your cause.
All right, I'll find something for you to do.
An opportunity is all I ask. Thank you, my lord. I will submit my reassignment papers as we depart.
Prentice, I see you are ready to put Balmora behind you. Good. The elimination of Commander Rylon grants security to my spy network, but there is still more to be done.
It's always work, work, work with you.
When all this is over, there will be time to relax. Now, before I unleash you on Noman Carr and his Padawan, you must eliminate my spy on Nar Shaddaa. Head there immediately.
My updated galactic history data indicates I missed depressingly little during my unscheduled shutdown. I am disappointed to note the Republic still stands. The sacking of Coruscant was impressive, but the Empire failed to finish liquidating the enemy. That peace treaty was highly inefficient, Master.
Inefficient? What makes you say that?
Instruction. Pausing in the middle of liquidating undesirables allows them to gather strength and potentially regroup. This creates extra work for you. Fact, the Empire needs a dedicated efficiency expert like myself. There is substantial room for improvement of its annihilation procedures. The Sith spend as much time fighting each other as they do the Jedi. This is simply wasteful.
Sith are strong because we eliminate the weak among us.
Observation. While I fully support liquidation as a problem-solving strategy, it seems wise to pause inter-Sith hostilities until the Jedi are eradicated. Conclusion. I will dedicate a small portion of my processors to developing new efficiency-increasing methods. I will inform you when I have recommendations. Until then, we should resume liquidating the undesirables. They have lived far too long.
My lord, I have settled into my quarters and fully acquainted myself with the ship. I am at your disposal.
I'm not sure what to do with you, Quinn.
I volunteer for any and all duties, my lord. I hope you'll find my military acumen useful. And I am completely familiar with this vessel and can both navigate and pilot.
You'd better come in handy in the field as well.
I look forward to showing you what I'm capable of, my lord.
Pleasure to greet you, my lord. I am MQ-12, liaison to the Ministry of War's Mercenary Recruitment Division. I find appropriate employment for talented freelance soldiers serving the Empire. Would you be interested in acquiring a combatant who achieved a perfect score on the Megas Aggression Index?
I've never heard of this Aggression Index before. Explain it.
The test measures an individual's psychological predisposition toward violence and effectiveness at channeling hostility during combat encounters. Perfect scores are exceedingly rare. The Science Bureau has classified this mercenary as a hopelessly primitive creature from an undeveloped outer rim system, but judged it as useful nonetheless. It has previously served Imperial interests on Nar Shaddaa, and displayed noteworthy commitment to our cause by eliminating a dozen resistance groups on Balmora.
I wouldn't expect that kind of enthusiasm and devotion from a mercenary.
The Science Bureau performed a thorough psychological examination before releasing it. The subject rated highly for obedience, ambition, and excessive pride in its accomplishments. Judge for yourself. It understands our language well enough and will respond in its own crude fashion. The subject calls itself Treak.
Ooh, Uichunna di Giovamate. Luka payan pachikara asapa. Wakata kola kale karavani kataroko.
You're eager to serve. Do you know what it means to bind your fate to a Sith Lord?
Kini chato lordo jirima mamomotak nubroda. Pibokachi no kakishi chachik. Ano jovicho ajo pania maria yoda. Rokana kara reyam chachim avadukamia karechi.
Welcome to my crew, Treak. Your contract with me begins immediately. Ready?
Kobaji jazabo. Amisoro bagavindija papukoja. Karani kete abdos oyachi. Akayam, opakaya kimata. Samajikava svaro da baharo chikichiya. Kokasa otomnati.
I am pleased you found my offering worthwhile, my lord. I will report our success to the Ministry of War. Good day.
I assume you've settled in?
Trana paravora, nabalale. Na, aitan, sudi amamenti mamani, avaka, vicheta karka vobe papatasi. Son wicho rita tasida. Ano jo wicho, ajo pania maria yoda. Rokana kara reyam chechein, avadukam ya kare chi. Amia, kasono, mandidarete tutuchige, sudi antam panimbo putovam, e kanana babaji chokota.
I don't know anything about your homeworld or its people. What are they like?
Ajuda sabo se satarita se ja reda paperik elemo mulakatam mateka. Amia kasana mandi darete tutuchige sodi antam panimbo putovam kanana babaji chokota. Taraka fita sono ne au fosi jameni timana davano ya bija katala bala dasta video operas tutto se chimi sata.
If you wiped out the whole crew, who was left to repair the vessel so you could leave?
Kayam, opakaya kimata, samajikava svaro da baharo chikichiya, kokasa otomnati. Eka biatinia adarita la bobeka jime, chimine karana kite jutoda mime mata anapakora, anunisela.
Since you aren't flying around the galaxy on your own, I assume you lost that starship you captured.
Modamate mukama, dios ete vihata hovena modavedi mime. Milati dvara jovie. Kama sinchika Japania agidato gorevavare. Avijuta, Batistian ki ambesi samparka, Gario Grupo Kashkaya.
Apprentice. I see you've landed on Nar Shaddaa. It is, I'm afraid, the armpit of the galaxy.
Must be your kind of place, Barriss.
In my youth, perhaps. Nar Shaddaa is a planet of frivolity and distraction. Gambling, spice, rampant black market and gang territory disputes. But you are there to eliminate my spy, Agent Delicon. Normally it would be a trifling task, but Delicon has acquired a powerful ally.
Surely this person wouldn't dream of defying you.
He seems to relish it. Agent Delicon's new benefactor is a young Sith Lord named Rothari, an upstart who openly disrespects my methods. Rothari prefers a more blunt approach. The Dark Council has granted him dominion over Sith interests on Nar Shaddaa.
What possessed the Council to do such a thing?
Rothari has been effective at ingratiating himself to the Council. Agent Delicon knows much about my organization. I cannot have Rothari in possession of such a resource. Burn Rothari to the ground. Destroy everything he's working for. And kill Agent Delicon.
I see you're not averse to overkill.
This kind of defiance cannot be tolerated. Haladrel Setson runs my slave operation on Nar Shaddaa. She has been a valued operative for many years. She is ready to receive you and can fill you in on Rothari's movements and interests. That is all.
talk me all day, darling. The exchange is moving in on this operation of yours. No amount of sugar gonna change that.
Believe me, you're going to prefer the sugar to the spice. Take one step closer and there'll be 24 Sith surrounding you.
24? That's a dead giveaway, darling. You got none.
One is all she's going to need.
See? Not so smug now, are you, Captain?
So you do got a Sith up your sleeve. Well, we've been trained to take out Sith. Time to flex our muscles.
I've suffered you long enough.
Kill the Sith.
Better check if you still have all my parts.
I have a flair for dramatic entrances. I probably could have handled that, but I'm grateful for your timing. You're the apprentice Darth Barris prepped for me, yes?
What exactly did he tell you about me?
Barris told me why you're here and how I can help. He neglected to tell me how dashing you are.
And Barris failed to tell me what an alluring woman you are.
Well, well. A Sith with a beating heart. Halidrell sets in. So you're here to take out Lord Rothari. Won't be easy. He usually just appears, devastates, then disappears. You'll have to draw him out. He's been making some major power plays, and disrupting them will get his attention.
Sounds like a plan.
Barris trusts me for a reason. First, Rothari's been strong-arming the Hutt cartel. From what I hear, they're close to signing over some important territories to him. He and his apprentice Girik are in conference with the Hutts at cartel headquarters. If you burst in...
Rothari would be none too pleased.
Neither would the Hutts. The cartel is an Imperial ally. Rothari can't just beat on them. He has to play diplomat. Unfortunately, the same applies for you. If things turn violent between you and the Hutts, better if there's no one left to identify you.
There won't be a heart left beating.
It could get hairy. Those oversized slugs have some pretty buff bodyguards. When all this intrigue is over and Rothari is a memory, maybe we can get to know each other better.
That will definitely be in order.
I look forward to it. I have a feeling you and I will get along real well. I've got a shipment of slaves to send out, but I'll be here if you need me. Good luck, my lord.
You would be wise to bend to the great Lord Rathari's will. Sign over the specified territories before he loses his patience.
My new huts were spineless, but who knew they were gutless too?
I'll tell you who this is. This is the apprentice of an over-the-hill Sith named Darth Barris. Yes, that's right. My master and I anticipated your arrival.
Have you also anticipated your doom? Shut up, or I'll kill you and your men along with Rathari's toady. If you're stupid enough to stand against me, then you will die today. What are the odds you Hutts survive my attack?
Our alliance begins with the death of Barris' slave. Attack!
Did you scare me?
Lord Rathari will still be you and your master's downfall.
Find some self-respect, worm.
Yes, that is exactly what I intend to do. I die by my own hand, not yours.
Spread through the streets that Rathari's conference with the Huts was invaded and his apprentice killed. No one knows who slaughtered the Huts, so I'm very impressed. The Empire's alliance is intact. It's too bad Rathari wasn't in attendance. But man, I bet he's fuming.
I'm sure our message was heard loud and clear.
Rathari is also on the verge of taking over the Republic's base of operations in the upper industrial sites. With his work with the cartel dashed, he's sure to pour himself into squashing the Republic garrison.
I'll keep banging down doors until I find him.
I love a man who's tenacious. Even if Rathari isn't there, when his operations are all thwarted, I know he'll come to you. A confrontation will be inevitable.
What is the meaning of this? We are on the verge of striking a major blow to the Republic. I am General Clicton, commanding on the authority of Sith Lord Rathari, appointed to Nar Shaddaa by the Dark Council. Why do you attack the Empire's men?
If Rathari shows himself, no one else will suffer.
He is attending to other matters. You belong to Darth Barriss. I was given instructions to destroy you if you were foolish enough to show your face here.
I'm right here. Do what you must.
My men are the best trained in the galaxy. You will be a minor interruption, and then I will finish obliterating the Republic garrison. Full attack!
Sir, the Sith strength has been spent obliterating our enemy. We should strike while there's a chance.
After that display, Weglin, I believe fighting should be our last resort. Stay back and cover me. Sith, I am Commander Nolan. I'm in charge of this defensive. I'm unarmed.
You risk much approaching me weaponless.
I doubt that a blaster would save me. We do not wish a fight, but we also cannot relinquish this area. What are your terms?
You live only by my good grace. I may have need of you someday, and you will repay my mercy.
Very well. If your mission does not conflict with Republic interests, I pledge to help you. Here is my holofrequency. I will answer your call. You have my word. Until we meet again, Sith. Men! The battle is ended. Attend to the wounded.
My lord, my base! My base is under attack. The last of my men and I are holed up in the command center. But the doors are about to give.
I'll be right there, Haladrell. Try to hold on.
Do the best I can. But I've got a bad feeling about this. The command center's been breached. I've never seen such power. Oh no.
Clear, Darth Barriss failed to inform you exactly who you'd be crossing. This demonstration should make up for that deficiency. You want Agent Delacon, You want me? I won't be hard to find anymore. I'm on the roof of the satellite platform in network access. If you dare show, I will grant you a duel to the death. Be honored.
He's a moron if he thinks we're gonna walk into such an obvious ambush. Right?
Commander Norlin and his men owe me their lives. Hail him. I want to collect.
Oh, goody. I get to play secretary. Here you go.
I had a feeling you'd call, Sith. Can't say I'm looking forward to this.
You should be pleased to wipe the slate clean between us, Commander.
Believe me, I am. I just don't relish being obligated to do my enemy's bidding. A soldier pays his debts. Tell me what must be done.
Rathari, I presume. Finally, we come face to face.
Ah, you showed. You lack your master's caution. I applaud that. Delacon, Barriss's lackey is here. So, say your piece, and do it before I kill this would-be assassin.
Barriss is insane and paranoid. I was a faithful servant, and my cover was intact. Did he expect me to accept being murdered for reassurance? Just wait for death?
You knew the risks of the job when you took it.
And how to avoid them. Lord Rathari protects me now, and all of Barriss's secrets will be his.
In 100 years, when I am legendary within the Sith, your and Barriss's deaths at my hands will not even be a footnote. However, I would never lower myself to duel a mere apprentice such as you. You haven't earned the honor.
I'm ready to kill you, however you choose to engage me.
You are every bit as infuriating as your master. These men are my elite guard, trained to take on Sith. Half of them could kill you, but I don't like to play favorites.
Your men are going to be a little busy with my men.
That's the signal, men! Let's go!
I see now. I've underestimated your resourcefulness. Men, make quick work of these Republic fools! Attack! Yield. Never have I witnessed such raw power. The day and the planet are yours. I freely pass the scepter. The threat Delacon posed to you and your master has died with him. I hope it ingratiates me in some way.
You shouldn't have killed him.
Why? Barriss would not have accepted a show of mercy. And you must not cross him. Yet. It's clear to me now. Someday you will rise above your master. It is you, not I, who will be Darth Barriss's end. Grant me mercy, so I may live to see it. Honor me with some small hand in it.
I make you my minion to be called into service when I see fit.
Yes. I shall wait with patience for your summons. I leave you to your business, my lord. Remember, I am at your disposal, whenever you may seek to topple Barriss.
From here on, that is your only interest in the galaxy.
You have siphoned all other ambition from me.
All right, Sith. Now no one's left but you and me and my men. Your objective has been met. May we go.
You
have served me well, Commander. Leave in peace.
All right, men. You heard the Sith. Let's get back to our neck of the woods.
Glad this is finally over. Maybe we can go back to the ship and get off this rock, huh?
You haven't enjoyed Nar Shaddaa, Vet?
What's to enjoy? So dark and scummy. Ugh, gives me the creeps. I just can't wait to get back to my quarters and grab some shut-eye.
What does family mean to you? I mean, does it have to be the people you're actually related to?
When you are close to people, they become family. Sometimes, whether you want them to or not.
Cute. I'm going to take that as a compliment. When I was working for Noctrian, doing the pirate thief thing, he had a daughter my age, Risha. It wasn't like Noct was super sweet to her or anything. But he'd call her princess, and I wished I was her.
Having someone your own age could be great or terrible, depending.
It was great. Always great. Risha was smart and strong. She knew how to do everything around the ship. And I went everywhere with her. Suddenly I had a sister again. For years it was Risha and me against the galaxy and anyone who gave us grief.
Memories of the best times in life are treasures later in life.
Who are you and what did you do with the Sith I know? Eventually, Nock hatched some secret plan that I couldn't be a part of. One that apparently got them both killed. But for a while there, I really was happy. Enough of that.
I've done well, my apprentice. Delacon eliminated and Lord Rathori dispelled. This will be a day long remembered. The loss of Haladrel Sitson is unfortunate, but the ends far justify the means.
As long as you get what you want, the ends always justify the means, don't they?
Power depends on seeing the big picture. You have successfully eliminated both of my compromised agents. The time has come to set our sights on Noman Carr and his gifted Padawan. It seems our adversary is of like mind. Your efforts have not gone unnoticed. Noman Carr has been busy.
I wouldn't expect him to be complacent.
Good. Then you're less likely to be caught unaware. It appears your ship is being tracked. A very sophisticated sensor is reporting your every movement. I've traced the signal to a spaceport in a sector not far from you. I'm sure Noman Carr is involved.
Sounds to me like you're being paranoid.
I do not appreciate your doubt. I expect unwavering respect at all times. Consider yourself warned. I've sent the coordinates to your mainframe. Head there immediately, dock with the station, and make a lasting impression.
So concerned.
Master Carr, you promised we would be undetected, but the ship we've been tracking for you is here.
Calm your fear, Hiroshio. It will not serve you. I will speak with your visitor when the time comes.
The fear I inspire cannot be suppressed, Jedi.
Okay. You never told me we'd be tracking a Sith.
You were provided the details necessary to perform your duties. Now please, remain quiet. Sith, I presume you are Darth Barriss' new apprentice. I am Jedi Master Norman Carr. Do you know me?
Will you be disappointed if I don't?
I have a long history with your master. Barriss and I like to keep tabs on each other, so when I heard of a new apprentice, I investigated. These men were merely monitoring the equipment, following orders. There's no need for bloodshed here.
My quarrel is with you, Jedi. These men need not suffer.
Your temperance is remarkable. Hiroshio, please leave with your men immediately.
Thank you. Thank you, Master Carr. And you as well, Sith.
Get out of here.
Now that they're safe, I'll speak plainly. I know Barriss has spies, and I know you were sent to extract two of them before they could be exposed. But I'll soon have the proof I need. Barriss' spies can't hide for long.
Your pupil's powers are a sham. She is leading you on a witch hunt.
You know more than I thought. Barriss, no doubt, is after my Padawan. How unfortunate. I've kept her identity and location a secret. So you and your master are just feeling your way in the dark. But my Padawan is of supreme importance to me in the Jedi Order. I will not let harm come to her.
I would expect nothing less.
In that case, I shall exceed your expectations, my friend. Forgive the earlier deception, Sith. But now that Hiroshio and his men have escaped harm, I must neutralize you immediately. These troopers are among the Republic's finest. Surrender, and the Jedi Council will be lenient.
You're digging your own grave.
And you leave me no choice. Men, take the Sith in, by any means necessary. Seems Darth Barriss has found himself a singularly vicious weapon in you. This experience has given me valuable insight. I'll be prepared for you next time, Sith.
I was holding back. I fought them with one eye closed.
You cannot get under my skin with your antics. My place is by my Padawan's side, teaching her the ways of the Force and honing her talents. I will do everything in my power to keep her hidden from you.
I'm talking to a dead man.
Until we meet again.